First we heard about Star Wars Squadrons was a few months ago when a Twitter bot found an unlisted description of the game online. With the benefit of hindsight, let's see how accurate this Twitter bot was.
Hello, what have we here?
If you haven't seen the first video I made about this game, look in the description for the link to it. That video goes into more detail with what was revealed at the time. There's also a link to all three trailers if you haven't seen them yet. In March of 2020, it was claimed that a Twitter bot scraped information from the PlayStation Store of an unlisted upcoming Star Wars game. There was a graphic with a brief description which created an instant online buzz with the possibilities of what this game could be about. At this time, we knew it as Project Maverick. The artwork showed a Star Destroyer with several X-Wings approaching it. This strongly hinted that the game fell into the original trilogy period. It was also suggested that this will be a multiplayer game that allowed up to 5 players to play together in a multiplayer mode. It was rumored that the game would only be released on consoles, and some people were suggesting that this game would not be VR compatible. Since this game was first leaked, we have learned much more about this game through many of the trailers that have been released for it. Some of the rumors have turned into facts. The game does take part in the Age of Rebellion, aka the original trilogy part of the Star Wars timeline. Not only can you play the game with 4 other players on your team, you can battle teams of 5 other players. So the rumors that this game could have 5 players playing simultaneously was true, with the added enemy team making it up to 10 players. Many PC players were relieved when it was announced that Star Wars Squadrons would be released not just on consoles, but also on the PC. This game is also cross-platform compatible. So if you play on the PlayStation 4, but your friend Andre plays on the PC, and your other friend Caleb plays on the Xbox, everyone can now join the game no matter which platform you are on. The rumors that this game would not be compatible with VR have turned out to be completely false. In the trailers, we learned that the whole game can be played in VR. So the next time a Twitter bot claims to have scraped information from an online store about an unannounced Star Wars game, we should listen to it and remember that it has been a reliable source of information in the past. Several Star Wars characters have appeared in the trailers, including Princess Leia, Hera Syndulla, Wedge Antilles, and Admiral Sloan. I wouldn't be surprised if we also saw Luke Skywalker and Admiral Akbar making an appearance, along with Iden Versio from Star Wars Battlefront 2. Also, depending on how far in time this story goes, I suspect we could also see Grand Admiral Thrawn show his face. If future content is released, I'd like to see the Falcon, piloted by Han and Chewie, to become a playable vehicle. The release date for this game is not far away. Let me know in the comments if you already have a squadron put together to play this game with you. If you're new here and you enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing. It would really help out the channel and you'll be able to stay up to date with all the latest Star Wars rumors. Thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next video. And remember, it doesn't matter what galaxy you're in, Jesus is Lord.